الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم ما بعد، الإمام النووي رحمه الله تعالى يقول في رياض الصالحين في كتاب آداب النوم، The Book of the Etiquette of Sleeping from رياض الصالحين، قال: باب ما يقوله عند النوم، The chapter what to be said, what is to be said at the time of sleeping. وعن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها قال: كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يصلي من الليل 11 ركعة، فإذا طلع الفجر صلى ركعتين خفيفتين، ثم اضطجع على شقه الأيمن حتى يجيء المؤذن فيؤذنه. متفق عليه، يعني يؤذنه بالصلاة الإقامة. In this hadith, عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, she reported that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to offer 11 ركعة of قيام الليل. Now 11 ركعة, how do you calculate these 11 ركعة? Eight of these rak'ah will count as his tahajjud, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and three will be his witr, salawatullahi wa sallam. So eight rak'ah, in this case, will be his qiyamul layl, and the three will be witr. That's according to Hadith Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, that the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he never prayed more than this amount. She mentioned that he never prayed more than this amount, whether in Ramadan or outside the month of Ramadan. He maintained that number, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. However, the quality was definitely amazing. She said, كان يصلي ركعتين أو أربعا فلا تسع عن حسنهن وطولهن. He would pray four. He says, so long and beautiful. And then he would pray four, so long and so beautiful. So the quality matters here. When it comes to صلاة النبي صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. When he used to finish his قيام الليل صلى الله عليه وسلم, قالت حتى فإذا طلع الفجر صلى ركعتين خفيفتين. When it's about when it's time for Fajr, he would offer two short rak'ah, make them very light, two rak'ah after Adhan al-Fajr. Now these two rak'ah became a source of controversy among some of the fuqaha. What are these two rak'ah that he used to pray after doing his tahajjud? Are these something extra right after tahajjud, which is according to Madhab Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala? Some of the fuqaha Madhab Abu Hanifa, they say that even after you do your last witr, you do two rak'ah, and you do them while you're seated. So you stay seated and then you make two rak'ah. And you make them very light. Now, the controversy is, why did the Prophet ﷺ pray these two rak'ah? Were they nafil? Were they part of the qiyam al-layl? And why did he do that ﷺ when he was seated? So does it make it a sunnah for me and you who's mashallah healthy and can stand up right now to make these two rak'ah when he was seated? Again, according to Madhab Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala, yeah, this is an extra two rak'ah to be done after witr. You do them very light and also to be done basically while seated. Another hadith explained those two rak'ahs. The Prophet ﷺ, he used to pray until it's almost sometimes Fajr time. Right until Fajr time. And that's what the meaning of this word. فَإِذَا طَلَعَ الْفَجْرِ. When it's Fajr time already, he would pray two rak'ah and he would make them very short and light. خَلِيفَتَيْن. حَتَّى نُعَائِشَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهَا, She said sometimes he would recite these two rak'ah and I would even wonder if he even finished the Fatiha. Which means you were very fast, kind of relatively fast. Now of course his recitation is different than ours, yeah. So when it's considered short and light, I'm still assuming perhaps still longer than our two rak'ahs. But eventually she said he would do the sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very lightly and make it quickly. ثُمَّ اضْطَجَعَ عَلَى شِقِّ الْأَيْمَنِ. Then he would lie down on his right side. He would lie down on the right side, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These two rak'ahs, according to this narration, basically would count as his sunnat al-fajr. Sunnat al-fajr. He would do sunnat al-fajr, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He would make them very light. Sometimes, as Aisha she mentioned, I would even wonder sometimes if he recited Surah al-Fatiha. So to show how light and how fast these two rak'ahs were. Also, when the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, used to make these two rak'ahs, this would be towards the end of his qiyam al-layl. Right at the end of his qiyam al-layl, particularly in the last maybe year of his life, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as he got older, and now he's being prepared, you know, to depart from this world, this life, he starts physically getting weaker. So he used to recite his tahajjud when he's seated, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he would sit down in tahajjud. However, he starts his salah normally as he stands up. He recites about 50 ayat, and then he sits down, and he keeps reciting until almost to the end of his recitation, right before maybe 50 ayat of his recitation, the end of his recitation, he would stand up and he would recite them while he's standing, and then he would go to the ruku' and sujood normally. But later on, when he was unable to do that, he would sit down as he would make his salah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why perhaps the Prophet ﷺ did these two rak'ah lightly while he was sitting because he was too tired from the long of Qiyamul Layl. So he makes them that for that reason. So alhamdulillah, if Allah blessed you with strength and with power, there is no meaning for you to sit down to make your sunnah. But if you have a situation, an illness, age, injury, whatsoever, and you have to sit down, alhamdulillah, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ. This is when you need to sit down. The Prophet ﷺ says in Hadith Amrah bin Husayn radiallahu ta'ala anhu, قَالَ صَلِّ قَائِمًا إِنْ اسْتَطَعْتُ. You pray while standing if you can. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَسْتَطَعْ فَقَاعِدْ. If you couldn't, then while seated. Means sit down. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَسْتَطَعْ فَعَلَى جَمْ. Basically, if you couldn't, then at least you just lie down and make your salah. So basically, you pray in the best way possible. If you can't stand up, you cannot sit down when you pray. You cannot do that. And if you couldn't sit down, then in this case, you just lie down and make your salah. The last portion of the hadith, she said that ثُمَّ طَجَعْ عَلَى شِقِّهِ الْأَيْمَنِ حَتَّى يَجِئَ الْمُؤَدِّنُ فَيُؤْذِنَ. She said that he would lie down on his side, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until the Mu'addin Bilal, in many cases, he would come and call him for the iqam. Ya Rasulullah, it's time. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would stand up and he would go to the salah. Now what's the point of this, you know, this position, this posture to lie down on the side until the iqam is called? The ulama, they say the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to rest. He used to rest from the salah, the long qiyamul layl. So he was just basically resting until Bilal calls him to come and leave Salat al-Fajr. Did he sleep sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this position? Now some of the fuqaha, they say if you sleep, but not that deep sleep, which means if you can still feel the surroundings, you can hear the sounds and the voices and so on, then that's okay. In this case, your wudu is still valid. Although according to Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, basically it's considered not valid because this position is an easy position to fall asleep and perhaps break wudu. But if you still feel the surrounding, then you still have your wudu and you could move on to the salah afterward. But if you lost it, then in this case you need to make wudu again. The Prophet ﷺ used to rest and then wake up for Salat al-Fajr. Not wake up, but basically he would stand up for Salat al-Fajr, salawat Allahi wa sallam. So therefore, is this his sunnah? Is it sunnah after you pray two rak'ah, sunnah al-Fajr, that you lie down in the masjid? Ya Jama'ah. And imagine I come here to Salat al-Fajr and see, oh, the whole masjid, mashallah, is on their side because they did their sunnah. You know, you guys laughing at it? According to Madhab al-Dahiriya, Imam ibn Hazm rahimahullah ta'ala, it's considered part of the salah. Which means if you don't lie down on your side after Salat al-Fajr, your salah will not count for you. To that extent, at some extreme opinions, if you don't make that position, your salah is invalid. But still, we need to put things in perspective. When the Prophet did what he did, first of all, he was not legislating anything particular about salah. Second, he did it when he was resting from a long Qiyamul Layl. So yeah, if you woke up for Qiyamul Layl, and then you come to Salat al-Fajr, you pray the Sunnah, the Imam is not here yet, or it's going to take me another 5-10 minutes before they call the Iqamah, should I rest on my right side? Please, be my guest. What the people are going to say? It doesn't matter what the people will say. As long as you do it in the back of the masjid, not in the first line. Yeah. Yeah, you do it somewhere in the back, rest until they call the Iqamah, then you move on, inshallah, forward. But to come and preserve the first line and lie down on your side, I don't think this is appropriate. So the point here is that if you had long Qiyamul Layl and you prayed two rak'ah Sunnah al-Fajr and the Iqamah is not called for, then rest on your right side. But if it just when you woke up from a long night sleep and you're coming here to rest from that long night sleep, no, there's not actually any time for that. You need to stay up until you call the Iqamah. And then you pray Salat al-Fajr. Wallahu ta'ala. Any question? Go on.
Chef, head or feet first, so it's the Qibla.
They say at this position, do you face the Qibla or do you put your feet towards the Qibla? Well, I think you should face the Qibla is better for you. They say if you sleep on your side, facing the Qibla. Wallahu ta'ala.
Is it better to pray Salat al-Fajr at home?
Is it better to pray Salat al-Fajr at home or in the masjid? Any salah besides the fard salah is better to be performed at home. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal khayru salat al-mar'i fi baytihi illa al-maktuba. The best salah performed is the one that you perform in the house except for the obligatory one. That needs to be done in the masjid. So including salat al-sunnat al-fajr, if you can make it at home and then come to the masjid, you should be fine, inshallah.
If you come to the salah in the fajr time and the salah has already started, and you miss the sunnah, do you make it up afterwards or not?
If you miss the sunnah, if you come to the masjid for fajr and the imam is already reciting the qira'ah, or in salah in general, join the imam right away. Mm-hmm. And then you make up that sunnah, inshallah, after the salah.
You do make it up.
Make it up after the salah, inshallah. That's exclusively for fajr and also for witr, you can make it up. Nah.
Same for Hanafi?
Well, if you talk about the Hanafi, no, they have different opinions. The Hanafi, they say, even if the imam is reciting the fard, you should make your sunnah. As long as you can catch the part of the salah with the imam. For me, this is honestly, this is not yani a valid opinion. Or it's not the correct opinion. It's perhaps valid in the Hanafi opinion, but the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِذَا أُقِيمَتُ الصَّلَاةِ فَلَا صَلَاةَ إِلَّا الْمَكْتُوبَةِ When the fard is called for, there should be no other salah performed except for the obligatory one. Also, there's different value between the sunnah and the fard. And even if it was the sunnah of Fajr, which is something the Prophet ﷺ, he never missed, whether he was traveling or he was a resident, ﷺ, he always prayed sunnah of Fajr. Still though, it is not considered fard, and therefore should not delay joining the fard salah just to perform the sunnah. Yeah, but I would like to join in to take the reward for the sunnah. Do it after the fard. Should be fine, inshallah.
Right after.
Now, some of the Malikis, they say that if you're going to have to do that, then pray the sunnah outside the masjid. And then come and join it. Wallah. Nah. Yes.
So what time Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to sleep? All night long he has been worshipping. So what time
the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to spend his time sleeping? Well, the Prophet, he would never stay the entire night yani awake for Qiyam al-Layl. I should say the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would always rest. Yani. He said that the best performance of Qiyam al-Layl is the performance of Dawud alayhi salam. He would sleep one third of the night, and then he would wake up for one half, and then he would rest the last sixth of the night. Sometimes his salah would extend until Fajr time, but eventually he always takes a nap during the day, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to rest and also to energize. The other thing is that the only time that we know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he remained awake the entire night, would be the night of his i'tikaf in Ramadan, to stay up all night, and he would rest after Fajr, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallah. True, that's true. Keeping in mind, that why is it difficult for us to wake up for Fajr, for Qiyam al-Layl, even for Fajr, subhanAllah, sometimes? It's because we don't count the night for us until it's past midnight. And as long as it's yet before midnight, we're still part of the day. So therefore, those hours that don't count. I mean, right now it's almost 10, so we have 2 hours until midnight, right? So everybody's just saying, until midnight, inshallah, I still have some time. This time, the Sahaba and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and actually even normal people, yeah, before the invention of electricity, they used to sleep, so they could wake up early. Now, the time that the work, yeah, the work time that they provide for you guys, is to reward your laziness. That's why most of our jobs or work, they work start at 8 o'clock, and some stores they open at 10 and 11. Subhanallah. Why is that? Because people are sleeping. They sleep through the Fajr and through the time, the beginning of the day, and they spend the night awake just like we do. Allah understand. SubhanAllah, alhamdulillah, shukran, astaghfirullah, wa atubu ilayk.